Good morning, it's 5:11, and this week we are exploring with Sven. Now, as you know, Sven goes on a lot of adventures all over the world.
And he's doing something to make sure all Minnesotans share in the experience and learn from Sven's travels as well. Let's get right to him. He's live in St. Paul this morning. What are we going to learn from you this morning, Sven?
Well, you know, a lot of people might wonder, what's the connection between a black rhino in, say, South Africa and a giant woolly mammoth or the Ice Age or us? Well, they're all are tied together. And just put this in perspective, we all know that we were covered in ice at one time. In the last Ice Age, 11,000 years ago, you can see all of the area that was covered in ice, except for, if you've ever been to Bluff Country, southeastern Minnesota, southwestern Wisconsin, they were missed by the last glaciers. That's why it looks so different there. So a lot of things have happened. Our climate's always changing, getting warmer, getting colder. We spend most of our time in modern climate in an ice age. So why am I in front of a giant woolly mammoth? These guys used to roam here. This is a replica of a woolly mammoth. Look how massive the thing is. But there are a lot of giant creatures roaming North America and the world. And in almost the blink of an eye, they were gone. Was it climate? Was it an asteroid? Was it a volcano? Here's how that happened.
I'm kicking off this whole week talking about climate change and extinction, and we're doing it in front of a big woolly mammoth at the Bell Museum.
Because the woolly mammoth is extinct and the rhino and the giraffe can go extinct.
That's right. Do you know how the woolly mammoth went extinct?
Ice Age. It might be because maybe a while ago the hunters, that was one of like maybe the big animals to hunt, and so they went extinct because too many people were hunting them.
So we probably played some role.
I think it's really hard to avoid that as a conclusion, personally. Two main ideas are that it was climate change associated with the end of the last ice age, basically a warming process. A lot of people adhere to that, the notion that the climate change was stressing out the populations of these animals, and then the arrival of this novel and very sophisticated predator, humans, was sort of the final blow, essentially.
The answers are complex. Climate change and extinction is nothing new. Earth is always changing. Minnesota, for example, hundreds of millions of years ago, was near the equator. Some of the biggest changes in climate have been from massive volcanic eruptions that split continents.
Ooh, what's in this one?
Signs of which are still visible, like this rock, basalt and quartz, literally air bubbles trapped in lava during the time that modern-day Namibia and Argentina broke apart. All of these giant creatures lived alongside humans at one time just thousands of years ago. 9-foot-tall sloth, a Volkswagen-sized armadillo, even a woolly rhinoceros. To see ice-covered landscapes now, we need to travel to the planets Arctic or Antarctic, places that are changing rapidly, sending Earth into modern chaos.
And that's the complex answer. You know, I asked Dr. Fox, why were all the animals so big in the last ice age? And he said, the better question to ask is, why are there so few big animals now? And it's probably because of a combination of the planet warming up at the end of the last ice age. But these guys had gone through lots of freeze-thaw cycles. The one thing that was different was us, human beings. Our ancestors were really starting to spread across the planet, not only hunting these guys, but competing for resources. So big predators like the giant saber-toothed cat, for example, just couldn't survive alongside us for that period of time. And that's what we're seeing around the world right now, as we're encroaching in habitats of animals, overhunting or poaching, in the case of illegal poaching with a black rhino. But also, we're warming up the planet, and this time it's not a natural thing. Most of the warming now is because of us. So it's kind of a double whammy at this point. But we're going to talk more about what's going on specifically in the Arctic, introduce you to Svalbard, where I was in August, and show you why we're there, because it's one of the most dramatically changing places on the planet right now.
Mm. Armadillo, size of a Volkswagen. I can't get over that.
That stuck out to me too, Sven.
Can you imagine?
I know, I can't. Very interesting stuff. Thank you. We'll check back.